You're watching Reality Check. Tonight, a closer look at the standout announcement in this government's final budget and one which may impact the election narrative. The scheme to give 6,000 rupees a year to small and marginal farmers, which will run up a whopping bill. Here's a reminder what the finance minister said on the floor of parliament.
This program will be funded 100% by the government of India. Kareeb 12 crore kisan parivaron ka isse seedha laabh milega. Ye program 1 December 2018 se hi lagu kiya jayega. Aur pehli kisht 2000 rupaye ki jaldi suchiya bana ke unke khate mein bheji jayegi. कार्यक्रम का अनुमानित खर्चा 75,000 करोड़ रुपए सालाना सरकार भरेगी.
Okay, so several questions about this, including the obvious: is 6,000 rupees too little? But first, the matter of how the government arrived at the figure of 12 crore small and marginal farmer families or farmer households. Because remember, that's what we just heard the finance minister saying, and Professor Ramesh Chand, member of the Niti Aayog, someone who keeps an eye on the agricultural rural part of Niti Aayog, is with us. Let me just start with you, sir, because yeah. I understand you were also quite closely involved with the drafting, conceiving, or the discussion on this particular scheme. What is the source of this 12 crore farm family figure?
We have an agriculture census, which with the reference year of 1516, 201516,
yes,
has been published last year in September.
Yes.
So that is the latest and update available on how many farmers we have, what is the distribution of land holding. Hmm. So based on that, we have...
So you've taken the figure from the agricultural census?
Yeah, that is one source for taking number of small and marginal holdings.
Okay, because... Yeah. The agricultural census has, it says 12.5 crore small and marginal land holdings.
Yeah, yeah.
So that's talking of land holdings.
Yeah, households.
But you, no, but land holdings and households are different, because the minister mentioned 12 crore farm families, which are households, but the census is counting land holdings. So how can you draw a direct correlation?
The number of household and number of land holding will not be much different from each other.
They won't be.
You see, now if suppose there is one farmer, he has two sons.
Right.
They are having two different houses.
Right.
But they are operating their agriculture business as a one unit. They have common tractor. They have common two-wheel. They are not having separation of their fields.
That's fair enough. But what I'm trying to understand is. How is it automatically assumed that it's a direct, almost direct correlation? What if one farmer or one family has more than one land holding?
That's why we differentiate between ownership holding and operational land holding. A farmer can have, say, two pieces of land,
Or
he can have land holding at different places. But as long as he operates it as a one business entity, the concept for that is operational holding. So it is treated as one operational holding.
Okay, so you know, there's this sort of note or the guidelines or whatever which you put up, or rather the government put up on the website of the Ministry of Agriculture, which says, which seems to acknowledge, by the way, that there could be a discrepancy between land holdings and between households, because it says if a landholder farmer family has land parcels spread across different village revenue records, then the land will be pooled for determining the benefit.
Yes.
So this does acknowledge there could be a gap. So the actual figure may be less than 12 crores.
That's why it is the operational holding.
I see.
You see, the number may not be exactly 12.5 crore. It may be little less. And in some cases, it may be little more also.
Okay. So, we actually checked now to see where we could get data on land, not holdings, but on farmer families, small and marginal farmer families. Let's put that graphic up on the screen. There are two sources for this. The NSSO of 2013 actually counts households. And that is given an estimate of 7.8 crore small and marginal farmer households. Yeah. There's also a NABARD figure, which is about 8.7 crores. That's more recent. This is a bit of a gap, no? Between
NSSO survey is not a census.
Right.
If you look at how much area is covered by that NSSO survey you are referring, it is only 90 million hectares.
Right.
Whereas we have 140 million hectare net zone area.
Right.
So NSSO figures.
NSSO is a sample.
Yeah, it is a sample. So generally you will see, even if you take number of cultivator from NSSO,
okay,
you take number of cultivator from our population census,
right,
there is always a difference.
Okay. So just want to get a quick comment on this 12 crore figure from our panel, and then we'll move on to the most more controversial, or rather the most significant aspect of the price. Yogendra, this question about households and land holdings, is it, as the government seems to suggest, that easily interchangeable, or is there a bit of a concern there?
I think Professor Ramesh Chand is absolutely right. The whole problem, Vasu, is this. There is no data bank in the country which lists farmers by their household. So the government's information on farmers is only by their land holding. There is no other register at all, and that's where the real problem lies.
Okay.
He's quite right to say that NSSO is, after all, a sample survey. NABARD is based on a sample survey.
Right.
And census is a census. Of course, you believe the census. But the trouble is that the fact that you have a census doesn't mean that you actually have a list of farmers with their names, with their land holding patta, or you know, khasra, or whatever you call it in different parts of the country, and with a bank account. These are the three things you need in order to transfer money to them. To my mind, that data does not exist anywhere in the country.
I see. How will you get all this data? Because you don't have much time.
No, you see, there are multiple sources of data.
Hmm.
Any time you start this kind of welfare scheme, you will encounter some difficulty in the first year.
But what
it's
are the multiple sources?
Not that thing will be readily available.
What are the multiple sources?
No, I'm giving you one example.
Yes.
If you look at this agriculture census, it draws from revenue record.
Right.
It's not that it is just you go to a farmer, you ask them. It is built on revenue record.
Yes.
After getting information from revenue authority, then you approach the family to get information on other aspects.
So what is your source
then?
Yeah.
So this is one source.
What source? Revenue records.
No, this agriculture, revenue record.
Because as Yogendra said, the agriculture census won't give you that detailed information. No, it won't tell you the khasra number, the, you know, all those details.
But will not tell all those details?
Agriculture census.
Agriculture census is based on the record given by revenue department.
Right.
So revenue department is having this information that this is a khasra number, this particular land. The problem may be that in some cases the record may not be updated.
Yeah,
in
land
some
records
cases,
in this country.
In some cases, the division of land may not be shown against individual names.
So then how will you... It's a challenge.
It is a challenge.
Okay.
It is a challenge. But I just want to share one information with Yogendra ji also.
Hmm.
In this country, 7 crore farmers are taking crop loan.
Hmm.
Are we giving crop loan without any land records?
Hmm.
These 7 crore farmers must be having some evidence to show that I have land.
Right.
That's why without that, you can't get crop loan. And another 6 crore take the term loan. Some farmer take both type of loan, that's why it does not...
Okay, so you are saying that also gives
so
you
that
some...
Is one basis. That is one basis for data.
Okay.
The second database is
your
soil health card. See, last three, four years, the number of soil health card which has been issued, that could be the second basis.
But by the way, I was told soil health card is again just land holding information.
Yeah, it's okay if it is land holding. So you can just collate it.
Okay.
That you can collect these different sources. I admit that in first year, difficulty have to be there. This scheme will put pressure on implementing agency, on states, district level authority to prepare the record where we can know.
Okay, at least you're candid enough to acknowledge that. Quick comment from you, Harish, and then I think Yogendra wants to intervene as well. Is this going to be a challenge in identifying beneficiaries?
Yes, it's going to be a challenge. See, the difference between, I think, the Telangana scheme and the central scheme is in Telangana, I think they first did a proper survey of, you know, I think they did sort of an updation of records, the revenue records and all these things, and then they implemented the scheme. Here you announce a scheme just, I mean, barely whatever, 2 months before the election. Now updating this in every state and all these things, it's going to take time, you know. So basically it shows that there was no seriousness in the scheme, you know. I mean, if you were to undertake such a kind of an exercise, you should have done it 1 year back, at least have all these this data ready, you know, and then announce the scheme. So now I don't know which are the states. So probably you may end up seeing the same Telangana and the same maybe Odisha again benefiting from these transfers, you know. So
I see, because they've already got
end up giving the money to the same lot of people.
Right, because they've already got their record.
Yes,
in
place. Maybe in UP.
Okay. Did you jump the gun a bit?
Yeah, hello.
You see, there's a
just a second, Harish, just a second.
There's a difference between Raitu Bandhu scheme and this PM Kisan.
No, I'm asking you on a different point. I'm saying, ki kya thodi jaldbazi because of elections, did you jump the gun a bit on the scheme?
No, you see, look at the situation. Why the need for this scheme?
Need is not in doubt.
No. I'm just saying you
need
that
is
why.
What is how much time some, frame there some, was the scheme discussed?
Some development happened recently, which make it must. You look at agriculture prices relative to non-agriculture prices. In 17-18, agriculture prices increased by 1%, prices paid by farmer increased by 4%.
Right.
This year, there is 0% increase in prices received by farmer for their produce, but prices paid by the farmer are non-agriculture prices, they are showing 5% increase. So, beginning with the 17-18,
yeah,
there is a very sharp decline in terms of...
No, but you didn't answer my question. Yeah. How much time was the scheme actually discussed before it was announced?
No, this scheme we have been, not this scheme, we have been discussing situation
since
of agriculture sector,
yes,
for more than 2-3 months. Because we came out...
2-3 months?
Yeah, I'm telling you, after this government came out with this ASHA, new MSP support,
okay,
we took stock of how it is implemented, whether farmers are receiving remunerative prices,
but sir,
or they are not.
But 2-3 months for such a big
scheme?
So,
in September, October, right, after this first season, after announcement,
yeah,
of PM ASHA, it was found that there is a problem with the prices. Farmer did
okay.
not did not
okay.
get remunerative
okay,
price.
Okay, so fine. And so you said, 2-3 months, so that could be a somewhat of a generous estimate. The actual figure may be slightly less.
You see, 2-3
Yogendra
months,
Yadav, you want to quickly
three
comment.
2-3 months is for scheme, not for land record.
Right.
You look at the effort which Government of India has been making with the states.
Okay.
Please digitize your record. Central government is
fair
paying
enough,
for
fair
it.
Enough, yeah. Fair enough. Yogendra, quickly, and then we move to the actual income part of it. Yeah.
Basu, the good thing about speaking to Professor Ramesh Chand, unlike many other bureaucrats of this government, you can have an honest conversation with him. So I think it's okay to now,
that's
think we
true.
Can reasonably conclude from this, number one, that when the finance minister announced that 2,000 rupees first installment will be sent to every house, everyone sitting there assumed that there already is a list which has name, khatra number, bank number, and the government would be able to transfer. The simple fact is, no such list exists as of now. Yes, khatra number exists. That's exactly what the agriculture census is all about. But something that would link it to a contact number, possibly a phone number, and more importantly, a bank account number, that does not exist at all anywhere in the records of the government. That, I think, is a consensus. I think Mr. Ramesh Chand said something very important in his passing remarks. He acknowledged, to my mind, this is the first official admission by this government that the price rise in this recent season after PM ASHA scheme has been 0%. I've been trying to ask this to many people in the government. Everyone evades it. Dr. Ramesh Chand, he is an expert, straightforward expert. So he acknowledges that price growth for farmers has been 0%.
No, I didn't
remember in the context
percent,
of all these things about doubling of farmers' income, etc.
Right.
And the cost of farmers have gone up 5%. So I think that begins to tell you the real crisis. And just one last thing.
Yes.
On whether the government had made up its mind earlier or not. To my mind, the government denied actually on the floor of the House that they had any such scheme. That was probably a few days before that.
Right.
And if you look at the detailed budget document and the speech, there is a discrepancy between the two. That, to my mind, shows that they made up their mind only on the last evening.
Very quick. It was a quick. So sorry. You wanted. Did you say 0%?
No.
You were saying you're shaking. You're saying 0%.
You see, if you look at it, okay, varies. Moving. If you look at prices of vegetable,
yeah,
they are lower by 17-18% compared to last year. Right. If you look at price of paddy, this year it was 3.8% more than what it was last year. Overall, right, if you look at the implicit price deflator,
yeah,
for agriculture sector as a whole,
yeah,
there is a 0% increase in agriculture prices this year compared to last year.
Now let us move to the question of the actual. If you move to the question of the actual income, and is this going to help? Because what you are paying is 6,000 rupees a year, and that comes to, as we know, 500 rupees a month. Now, the average farmer income, according to NSSO, is about 5,200 rupees a month. This is for small and marginal farmers. There's some variation across different databases, but broadly it's about in the range of 5,000 rupees a month. So this is only 10% of a farmer income.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't this too little?
There are different ways to looking at it. 75,000 crore rupee is equal to whatever total fertilizer subsidy this country has been giving.
Mm.
Now, will you say that fertilizer subsidy is just negligible?
Mm.
It has no meaning.
Mm.
You look at that 75,000 crore rupees equal to what is the provision we have made for fertilizer subsidy for the entire country for all category of farmers. So you ask a farmer whether fertilizer subsidy matter for you or not. Now you say if you reduce that, you divide first by 12, then you divide it by 30 to get per day, then you divide by 4 members.
I'm not doing that. Notice, by the way, I didn't get into that per day, per family calculation. I'm saying whichever way you slice it, it's only a 10% top up to the average farmer income.
Let me give you my number. The income which you are quoting is not agriculture income. That also include non-agriculture income. This support is meant to supplement agriculture income of the farmers,
right,
and statistics for 2018-19 are as under. 6,000 is enough to meet 40% cost of inputs for a small farmer whose cultivable land is only 0.53 hectare. You see what he spends on seed, on electricity, on diesel and all those things. So that is 45%.
Okay,
if you add hard labor into it, you find that 6,000 is 25% of the total cost paid by the farmer. And with 6,000, a farmer can buy 20 bags of urea.
Okay, let me just put that. Actually, Harish Damodaran did a IP Singh Saab se main puchna chahunga ki yahan kaha ja raha hai Singh Saab ki is 6,000 rupees se at least 40% cost आप मीट कर सकते हैं, लेकिन हरीश दामोदर ने एनालिसिस किया इंडियन एक्सप्रेस में, और उसमें से उन्होंने कहा कि अगर आप उसको तीन ट्रांचेस में बांटते हैं ना, 2000 2000 2000, तो 2000 रुपए के साथ आप क्या कर सकते हैं पर एकर कॉस्ट, व्हाट आर पीपल पेइंग? सो अ वीट फार्मर इज पेइंग हिज फर्टिलाइजर कॉस्ट पर एकर कम्स टू अबाउट 3,400 रुपीज, यू आर गिविंग ओनली 2,000. हार्वेस्टर कॉस्ट इज अबाउट 1,500 रुपीज, अगेन 2,000. हाउ डज दैट रियली हेल्प? BT cotton seeds, if you are a cotton farmer, per acre cost is about 1200 rupees. So Singh sahab, ye political jo aap iska laabh uthana chahte the, kya isse ek backlash ho sakta hai ki log kahenge ki bhai aap de rahe hain lekin aap to kuch de hi nahi rahe?
Dekhiye Srinivasan ji, ye mera manna hai ki Bharat badhti abadi aur ghatte sansadhanon ka desh hai. 86% jo किसान है आज उसके पास 5 एकड़ से कम जमीन बची हुई है, चाहे उत्तर प्रदेश, पश्चिम बंगाल, उड़ीसा या उधर आंध्रा, तमिलनाडु, इन सभी राज्यों को, अगर जो बड़े राज्य हैं या छोटे, उन्हीं सबको देखा जाए.
नहीं, लेकिन
लेकिन भारत सरकार का जो इंटरिम बजट है, एक मिनट, जो सुन लीजिए, मैं बता रहा हूं ना, जो भारत सरकार का इंटरिम बजट है, भारत सरकार ने कहा कि हम प्रति वर्ष 75,000 करोड़ रुपए किसानों को मदद देंगे. उत्तर प्रदेश सरकार ने जो उनका कर्ज था 38,000 करोड़ रुपए माफ किया, मध्य प्रदेश से लेकर तमाम करीब
नहीं नहीं उन पे कर्ज माफी भी नहीं
86,000 करोड़ रुपए से ज्यादा हमारी सरकारों ने माफ किया था। दूसरा यूरिया को लेकर चर्चा होती है, यूरिया को लेकर योगेंद्र जी लाठियां चलती थी, लेकिन जैसे ही माननीय मोदी जी देश के प्रधानमंत्री बने,
अरे सिंह साहब आप तो कहीं और ही चले गए,
अनइंटरप्टेड यूरिया मिले,
हम तो सिर्फ 6,000 की बात कर रहे थे।
समझ नहीं, ये सब बातें आनी बहुत जरूरी है, समझाना बहुत जरूरी है कि गरीब
अच्छा, किसान कुछ किसानों की आवाज चला दे।
योगेंद्र जी कितना गांव में जाते मैं नहीं जानता, कभी सेफोलॉजिस्ट कभी किसान कभी नेता,
अरे आप इसको व्यक्तिगत आप इसको कहां आप हमेशा व्यक्तिगत क्यों कर देते हैं।
4 दिन गांव में था, कहना देखिए किसान की जो पीड़ा है, किसान
अच्छा किसान की पीड़ा सुन ले, हम थोड़ी सी किसान के भी कुछ वॉइसेस हैं, एक सेकंड किसान नहीं किसान की आवाज सुनिए, किसान की आवाज।
15 गांव में गया, लोगों ने कहा 6,000 रुपए हमारे लिए बहुत है भैया।
अच्छा ठीक है,
75,000 करोड़ रुपए भारत सरकार इस फाइनेंशियल ईयर में देने जा रही है, और अच्छा, आगे हमें पूरी संभावना है कि जिस तरह से उसके उसकी जो कॉस्ट थी उस पर 1.5 गुना।
अच्छा सिंह साहब थोड़ा सा आपको औरों को भी मौका देना पड़ेगा,
दे रहे हैं।
यस, तो ऐसा है, लेट्स जस्ट लिसन टू, वी ट्राई टू गेट सम वॉइसेस ऑफ फार्मर्स फ्रॉम डिफरेंट स्टेट्स स्टार्टिंग विद उत्तर प्रदेश, वी वोंट हैव टाइम टू प्ले ऑल ऑफ देम, लेट्स जस्ट लिसन टू अ फ्यू।
राम सेवक जी, कितनी खेती है आपकी टोटल?
2.5 बीघा जी। 2.5 बीघा?
2.5 बीघा खेती है आपकी, ठीक है। ये बताइए इस 2.5 बीघे में पूरे साल में क्या लगाते हैं आप?
धान गेहूं बोते हैं बस,
एक बार धान एक बार गेहूं
जी।
तो ये जो 500 रुपए महीना एक तरह से देखा जाए आपको मिलेगा, इसको आप कैसे देखते हैं, आप कैसे खर्चा करेंगे, या कैसे मतलब आपको कोई इसका फायदा होगा इसका?
अरे हाँ फायदा का है नहीं, मतलब कुछ तो फायदा होगा करी।
जैसे कहाँ लगा पाएंगे पैसा?
ये पैसा कहाँ लगा पाएंगे? हाँ ये बाजार करे जाओ, साग सब्जी मामला खत्म
बस।
हाँ और क्या,
नहीं आप तो कह रहे हैं फायदा होगा।
अरे फायदा वाह फायदा और का।
जो सरकार ने 500 रुपए या 6,000 सालाना 500 रुपए महीने की धनराशि की घोषणा की है किसानों के लिए, तो ये आपके या आपके परिवार के या किसानी के लिए मदद करेगी?
कोई मदद नहीं करेगी, ये हमारा 17 रुपए प्रतिदिन हुआ, अगर 5 मेंबरों का हमारा परिवार है तो 3 रुपए प्रति दिन हमारे पास बचे हैं, तो 3 रुपए को तो ना तो 3 रुपए का कोई सिक्का है, ना ही कोई बच्चा भी नहीं लेता है, 3 रुपए का आता भी क्या है इसे महंगाई के जमाने में।
तो सरकार से आपकी क्या मांग है?
हम सरकार से मांगते हैं कि हम मांगते नहीं, भीख नहीं मांगते, हमारे को हमारी जिनकी फसलों का दाम है वो डॉक्टर स्वामीनाथन की रिपोर्ट के मुताबिक दिया जाए।
आत्माराम जी, कितना जमीन है आपका?
मेरे पास है करीबन 7 बीघा जमीन, 8 बीघा।
7 बीघा जमीन है तो आपका ये जो 7 बीघा जमीन में हर फसल में दो खरीफ और रबी की जो फसलें होती है, हाँ। कितना कितना किन किन चीजों में खर्च हो जाता है और क्या चीजों का उत्पादन आप करते हैं?
अभी मैंने आलू बोया, हाँ। तो 4 बीघा का तो करीबन उसमें 40,000 का तो खर्चा है, 50,000 का,
हाँ।
कितना? 50-60,000 का खर्चा है और आलू सब जल गए।
अब सरकार जो आप लोगों के लिए कह रही 6,000 रुपए साल वो आपके खाते में डालेगी, 500 रुपए महीना, तो क्या मानते हैं इस मदद को आप?
क्या है उसमें कोई फायदा नहीं सर इतने पैसे में,
क्यों?
थोड़ा बहुत ये खाद वाद में सपोर्ट मिल जाएंगे, ये है। फिर सरकार तो मदद 1,000 रुपए की भी दे तो अपने बीड़ी बिंडो का खर्चा हो जाए।
ओके पूजा मेहरा जॉइन्स अस, सीनियर जर्नलिस्ट, sorry we couldn't get you on earlier Pooja, but a quick word from you on what the government is saying, that they're saying look, don't quibble about the fact that farmers are only going to be getting 6,000 rupees, totally we are putting out 75,000 crore rupees, so we're taking a big hit.
That's right, they're taking a big hit, but the point is how much is each farmer going to get, because whatever is the total budget, the cost to the budget, that is of no concern to individual farmers. What matters is welfare of individual farmers, and every farmer is facing a loss because prices have crashed in the market. Prices have crashed because of faulty pricing policies, and there are only two ways: either policies have got to be fixed, or farmers have to be paid compensation for faulty policies. It's not the farmer's, you know, fault that he's facing losses.
Right, and Harish quickly. Harish, quickly on the point that Professor Chand was making, that look, it may look like a small amount, but it's helping you meet at least 30-40% of your agricultural cost.
See, I don't know a single crop where the spending per acre will be less than 15,000 rupees. okay? Minimum 15,000 rupees per acre is a cost. So even if you were to take a small farmer, 15,000 is say 5 acres. So 15 into 5 is 75,000. And what is this which we are giving? We are giving 2,000 rupees. 2,000 rupees out of 75,000. That is one crop. So this is, I mean, I think this is a joke.
You
know, if I were, I mean, there's no use calling it a farmer scheme, you know. Rather it would have been okay if this 2,000 rupees was given to everybody, you know, irrespective whether you're a farmer or a non-farmer, you know, to all poor people. So I'm more inclined to, you know, support the other scheme of identifying the poor and then giving them, you know, a certain sort of a support. Why call it a farmer scheme? You know, I mean, this cannot meet any farm. This cannot fund any farming activity.
Okay, last.
You know,
with
2,000 rupees, what can you cover? I mean, if I have five acres,
yeah.
then that means 400 rupees per acre. I mean,
okay, Pooja.
With 400 rupees per acre, what can I cover? Nothing.
Okay.
I can probably use 2 bags of urea. I mean,
okay.
Maximum.
Pooja, quickly,
you know?
Come in. We are out of time.
No, very quickly. What I wanted to add is that, you know, for middle class income tax payers, the government has given a tax op which at the minimum comes to about 12,000 rupees a year.
Right.
Where middle class has not suffered any losses of the kind that farmers have suffered.
Noted,
and middle
noted.
Class has actually gained because of the farmer price crashes.
Noted.
So, you know, it's not fair. Why are they getting twice the amount that farmers are getting?
Okay, I actually wanted to give Professor Chand the last word. Very unfair of him not to, but my producer is saying time is up, so I'm getting shouted at. Let's have you back. This is a bigger discussion.
I would like to sit with my friend Harish Damodaran tomorrow and show him
the
statistics.
Show him the math.
That the cost of input per acre in agriculture is less than 14,000.
Okay.
Labor cost is 10,000. It comes to 24,000.
Right.
6,000 is 25% of 14,000. This 24,000.
Okay, fine. All right. Okay. We'll leave it there. But thank you so much for watching. Reality Check. That's all the time we have. Good night.